the preliminary design out of this. So we can try several Glulam. We are instructed to use Glulam. So what are the factors involved in Glulam? We can list down all the factors for color. Okay. So we can try one. Let us go to the table appendix. Take note, Glulam, since it is already engineered product, it is specified in actual dimension, not nominal dimension, it is actual dimension. So when you are going to use the sold lumber, it is specified in nominal dimension. And whenever you have to compute area or inertia, you have to use for S4S. You have to use S4S. So now we don't have that problem anymore because we are using engineered lumber. So depending upon the size of the engineered lumber, that is the actual values we are going to use. We don't have to what? Clean. Okay? So let us from the table, we are going to try, for example, it says that we have to try what? 5 in 1/8 by 7 1/2. 7 1/2. Okay, inch. Okay. 5 in 1/8. Okay. 7. About the amount of glue. Okay. Let us try. So, if you try this out, can you compute area and section modulus? Let us compute area. So in the table, it is already computed. However, here, let us compute, for example, let us compute area. Multiply. How much that? 5 and 1/8 by 9 7. Compute modulus of section modulus, you have to compute this one. How much is this? 38.44. So area is 38.44. You multiply that, so that is okay. How much is this? So that we can calculate S I over C, which means how much? 180.
0.18.
So substitute it here and then divide by C. What is C? That is 1/2 of 7.5. So that is 7.5 times 0.5. How much is this? 48.05. Therefore, we have these values. So the book says 48.05. So the same, no? So the book is already tabulated, no? You can compute that. Well, that's how I wanted to show you that engineered product, Glulam, you don't have to shape anything. The given dimensions are the dimensions to be used in computation. Unlike in sole lumber, we have to shape the four sides we have to plane. Therefore, that's a let us do this 12 point. Let us take if our load is away. Okay, how much is this? This is a factor that we have to add. So this should be less than 1. You know? This is what? Axial. This is flexure. We are on the axial plus flexure load. So we have to what? Compute this to be less than 1. What is the amount? This is a test if the load is okay or not. What is this? Concentrated load. Axial. Axial load. Axial load. So this is actually axial plus flexure. Flexure meaning moment. So what is moment? Can you multiply this by 12? 3.2 times 12. So meaning the unit is inch, K. No? So not 15. Because of this, if the answer is greater than 1, then we cannot use this one. We have to use a bigger size. Oh, what is the value?
120.
Oh, okay, so this is less than 1. Therefore, this value, this size is over here. Right. So let us go to the Glulam. This is also 38.4 inch K. Okay. And then 38.44 is what? 38.45, this is what? So the only thing that I'm not explaining is 2.4 and also 3.37. What are those? Anybody would tell me? Okay, so 7. 1, 2. What are those? Okay. Let us continue. We have what? Less than 1, therefore this size is okay. Let us actually say that this is the four. Okay? Because we are trying. We are trying. We are trying if this dimension is okay. And we know that very small. Very small than 1. So we can actually try even smaller. So we can try smaller dimensions because it is very far from 1. Okay? We can go as far as what? 0.99, 0.98. This one is what? It's still bigger than the minimum required. So minimum required is if we have what? 0.99. We can try every size. For example, what? 4. 4 and 7 8. 4 and 7 8. We can try. Then, you know, compute. If you compute this one, you will notice. Try smaller. This will become smaller. Smaller number. Smaller. So this will become bigger. So bigger plus bigger is larger number. Will approach 1. It is logical. Yeah? It's logical. So therefore, we can try.